So I'll ask this question. Should MLB alter its voting process when it comes to the All-Star Game or the end of the year awards?
No and no. The All-Star Game, as JD talked about, is for the fans. This is, fortunately now, no longer determining home field advantage in the World Series. This is a showcase for the fans, a celebration of baseball, Midsummer Classic. It should be in the fans' hands there. Now, the postseason awards, interestingly, Mike and Rob, those, of course, as Rob knows, we vote on those. Mm-hmm. They are handed out by the Baseball Writers Association of America. So it's not MLB that hands them out. It's the writers. If JD wants to have his own awards, and call them the JD Awards. He can start his own awards if he wants to. But there are awards. I mean, Rob and I vote for them. So, and from that standpoint, we have realized a tradition in this game for a long time. The writers, they don't always get it right, but they usually do. And Rob, I think for now, we're okay in both areas.
No doubt about it. First of all, you're right. The All-Star Game is about the fans.
Yeah.
There are some fans who would rather see Aaron Judge strike out three times than somebody else hit. I'm serious. So we should allow the fans to see who they want. It's their game. Let them enjoy it. And as far as the awards, whenever I hear players say, oh, the writers shouldn't vote. What do we know? We should leave it up to the players and coaches. Barry Bonds was a great player, but wasn't a friend of the media. Not at all. Am I right, JP?
Right, correct.
Not at all. But Barry Bonds won 7 MVPs voted on by the writers. Why? Because he was that good. His numbers were that great.
Yes. And I would say this, too. And talking about the writers voting for Bonds, Rob, and you know this from that generation and even today, our votes now, because of social media, thank you very much, are now even more transparent than ever. We have to answer it on social media, on shows like this, because, as you know, Rob, your votes are all made public. So when you cast that ballot, any biases that may have existed in the past, to me, I think they're rooted out even more now than they were before because you have to answer for it to everybody.
And here's the problem when you talk about players voting. The NBA gave the right to players to vote in 2017.
Right.
There were 324 players. 128 didn't vote for LeBron James. 154
couple of haters out
didn't
there.
Vote for Kevin Durant. So there's an issue there. There's a conflict of interest. People are jealous. There's all kinds of cliques. So here it is. You think the players would know and everybody would do the right thing. It doesn't work out that way.
I got to police you a little bit on that because when it comes to the players, yes, there's a little jealousy sometimes when it comes to some of the star players and they want to vote for their buddies and not vote for guys like LeBron James. But can you tell me without a doubt that you guys, as esteemed as you are, and as great as you are, that there isn't a little bias when it comes to the way you vote? If there's a guy, if it's between one guy, two guys, and there's one guy that you like a little bit better personally, that you'll give him more of an edge over some guy that might be a little bit of a, you know what, butthole or something like that?
Well, to me, I know for me and Rob, I know you feel the same way. We study this so much. And we really do take a lot of pride in this. There was one year, and Rob, you may remember
not
this.
Not you personally, well, but I'm talking about other guys.
It could be, but I agree.
You know it
there,
is.
There was one year in 2012, Cy Young voting, I was one of the Detroit voters on that, and I voted for David Price. Had I voted for Verlander, Verlander would have won. I was a Detroit voter. I voted for David Price, then of the Tampa Bay Rays.
Oh, that went over well,
yeah, well,
didn't it?
My grandfather almost uninvited me for Thanksgiving that year. Okay,
But you got to do what's right, exactly, and what's honest.
And I told my grandfather, I said, listen, Grandpa, I did what I thought I had to do. David Price won 20 games. He won the ERA title in the American League East. I felt like he deserved it. And he said, son, you voted your conscience. I'm proud of you. So I really think, Rob, for us, and we talk about it in the press box all the time, you got to defend yourself to your colleagues, to the public. And I think, by and large, I know we take it seriously. I think we do a pretty good job.
I do, too. I think the writers really care. Those votes are precious. My Baseball Hall of Fame vote is the most prized possession that I own. And I really take time at it to make it to be right. I try to do the best job I can.
You do.
Well, you guys have morals and dignity. That's why I love working with you guys. There are some, like, especially in NFL, when they waited so long for T.O., to get it.
I get it.
Can't tell me that wasn't just about
things on the field. But their process, the football writers, I don't know.